Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Jennifer Day Live at Night. We are now streaming on YouTube, Facebook, and Twitch. Yay! It's Monday night, and we're going to have some fun. So in a minute, I'm going to start singing and dancing and get the show started so you guys can give me a call. Tonight, we are talking about our embarrassing moments. Tell me a funny story of an embarrassing moment that you had so you can have that in mind when you call. All right, let's get the show started here. And all your gifts I truly do adore. But I need something that's a little bit more. No, I'm afraid you can't find it in the store. I need to know I'm loved from my head to my feet. My kisses are divine and I'm good enough to eat. Material things are nice now and then. But I'm your woman, I need a more than a friend. You gotta tell me how you feel, cause that's the only way I know it's real. A gift of gab is more than a token. A word unsaid can mean a heart is broken. And if you ain't down with being free, you better say those words to me.
Oh,
I love you guys. Thank you so much for being here every Monday night with me. I really appreciate that. So tonight, let's talk about our embarrassing moments. let's have some fun enjoying each other's silliness. And we all have embarrassing moments. Silly things happen to us all the time. And you're like in the moment, you're so embarrassed and everybody gets a good laugh out of it. But at the end of the day, like it's a good story, right? So let me hear the good story. I have a couple for you too. So go ahead and give me a call and tell me. And I wanted to say thank you guys for tuning in last week. We had a really fun Cinco de Mayo special, a two-day special. And there are a couple songs I got to sing last week that I'm going to also sing tonight, too. So we get a really fun, good rendition of those songs for you guys making those requests. So thank you very much. And I wanted to do some thank yous for some donations that I didn't get to last week. So I really appreciate you guys donating and helping me continue to do this show with, you know, whether it's set equipment, you know, girls coming on, like all of the stuff takes so much funding. So I really appreciate the donations. Thank you. So I want to say thank you to Brian. You made a donation last week. Thank you so much for that. I appreciate it. And I'll put a fun little thank you donation on the screen for you so we can enjoy. Actually, let me just give you a little walk. I'll do that for a fun thank you. How about that? I'll give you a little spin. Yay! Live action dance for you. There you go. Thank you, Brian, for the donation. I appreciate it. Hello, you are on live with Jennifer. How's it going?
Hi there, Sunshine Girl.
Hi, Michael. How are you?
I'm good.
Oh, good. And I wanted to say thank you to you. You also gave me a donation last week, and I don't know if I got on the air to say thank you or not. So thank you for that. I appreciate it.
Oh, you're welcome. You're awesome.
Ah, thank you. You're awesome. How was your week?
It was good.
Good. Do you have a fun, embarrassing moment story to tell me?
Sure.
Okay.
First, I had a question for you.
Oh, okay.
I really liked your Instagram post this weekend.
Oh, thank you. That
picture with your mom was so beautiful.
Aw, thank you. I love her so much. She's amazing. Really, she was always there for me growing up, for me and my sisters and my dad. And just no matter what, like, whatever we asked, you know, if I forgot to bring something to school, whatever, like, she dropped everything and came. And I had lots of dance recitals and, you know, sports events and different things, that different activities and, like, you know, both my parents were always there for me. But just, you know, I had a really nice conversation with her on Mother's Day. I sent her some fun gifts. I have a tradition that I started a few years ago where I always send her artificial flowers, like small little flowers. So now kind of like her whole house and her business, like everything's decorated with these little flowers. So it's super cute. So now she can think of me every time, you know, she walks by, and they last forever, right? So, and then I got her... she really likes to read, so I got her this light that kind of sits, like it rests on your neck, around your neck, and it has little lights that kind of point down. So if you're reading something, it points at the book, and then you don't have to disturb other people around you. So she really liked that, too, so it was kind of fun. And we always have really good conversations, so shout out to my mom. Happy Mother's Day.
Well, they raised you right because you're awesome.
Oh, thank you. You're so sweet. Okay, so now for the funny stuff. Let me hear your embarrassing moment story.
Well, I remember one time in high school when, you know, if you went out with football, then after the season they had a ceremony where they called you up and you went and got your letter.
Oh, yeah, I remember.
Yeah. Well, I played high school football.
Okay.
And I was in the audience when they called my name. And I started walking up to the what do they call it, the lectern to get my letter. And everybody, you know, this chuckle started. And then pretty soon the whole audience was roaring with laughter.
Oh, no.
And I was so embarrassed. And I looked up and my parents were even laughing.
Oh, no.
And I thought, what did I do? You know, what have I done? And so I went and got my letter and I got back in the audience. And it turned out that I had a paperback in my pocket and the tails to the jacket were sticking straight out. So it looked like I had a tail.
Oh my goodness. That's funny. Well, hopefully, I mean, you know, at the moment, I'm sure it was really embarrassing, but now you can laugh at it, right?
Yeah. And there was one other time when I was in a play and I was wearing knickers. It was one of those turn of the century plays.
Yeah.
I don't remember what it was, but I was wearing knickers and it wasn't a comedy, but I came jumping out under the stage. And everybody busted up.
Okay.
I was really embarrassed that it was just me.
They were just laughing at the outfit you were wearing?
Yeah. I mean, I was kind of a class clown anyway.
Oh, my goodness. I actually have an embarrassing moment of when I was in a play. So that's funny that you mentioned that. So I was in high school. This was college, actually. This was like, I think, my first year of college. And so we were doing this very, like, serious dramatic play, right? And it was also a period piece. So when the characters were outside, they would always wear kind of these elaborate hats. And then inside, they would take the hats off. So that was the time period. I can't remember the year. That it was based, but it was called The Last Night of Ballyhoo, if anybody knows when that play was based. But I played one of the lead girls in the show, which was great. And we had done this show like maybe, I don't know, 10, 15 times over the course of several weeks. And so everybody knew their parts, like we were nailing it. It was awesome. And then the very last night of the play, we had an adjudicator, which they come and they review the play and they tell all the actors, you know, to kind of give a review on the performance just for learning, but also, you know, for the press and whatever. So it was like a really big deal. And of course, the very last night, there was one scene where I was coming in from, you know, the scene that I was doing outside, and I would always take this, it was like this huge elaborate hat that had this feather that kind of like stuck in my face here, and I would always take it off backstage and then go inside to do this scene. For some reason, I was maybe so nervous, I don't know, I forgot to take the hat off. So I walk in to do this scene, and the guy that's doing the scene with me, he just goes, and I was just like, hi, blah, blah, blah. I went into my scene, you know, and we were sitting on the couch and like the whole scene, it did not dawn on me that I had the hat on. And he's just looking at me like, how is this chick not know she has a hat on right now? The whole thing is just flying in the scene. It was just ridiculous. And then I, of course, got off stage and somebody was like, you have your hat on. I was like, oh my gosh. And I took it off and then we did the rest of the play. And I was so embarrassed. And then afterwards, you know, of course, the adjudicator was like complimenting the actors on the play and everything. And then he said, and what was going on with your hat there? And he mentioned it. And I was like, oh, my gosh, in front of everybody. I was so embarrassed. Like, it wasn't a big deal probably to anybody else. But to me, I was just like, because I was trying to be, you know, serious. I'm a performing actor, you know, and I was so embarrassed. But anyway, so I actually did do something that you know, nobody laughed, though. Everybody just was very silent until the end, and then they laughed. So, anyways.
Okay.
Well, thank you for your story. I'm glad we had a dual, like, getting in a play embarrassing moment story.
I did one other embarrassing thing last week.
Okay.
I sent a little present to someone.
And
there was supposed to be a card in it, but I forgot the card.
Oh. Well, I'm sure they knew your sentiment anyways.
I hope so, because it was you.
I know. Thank you so much for the gift. I really appreciate it. And I do. I know that you are very kind, and you always say such wonderful compliments to me. So I can imagine what the card would say. But you're welcome to still send it. I would love it.
That's because you're awesome.
Thank you. And thank you for the gift. It's really beautiful. I appreciate that.
You're very welcome. And you're beautiful tonight.
Oh, thank you. My bright orange. I thought I'd have some fun with that. And I did want to tell you that you requested a song called Just Want to Know. And I had been working on that this week for you. So I would love to sing that for you. Yay! And thank you for requesting it. I haven't done kind of like my pop rock energy songs in a while, so that'll be fun. So we'll do that for you.
Well, we haven't got time to talk about Quincy Jones.
To talk about who?
About Quincy Jones.
Oh, Quincy Jones, yes! So, yeah, you saw the post about that. I went to a Emmy event. They call it FYC, For Your Consideration, and they have the Emmy members come and, you know, talk about the different, you know, shows that are on Netflix right now. And so there's a documentary about Quincy Jones, and it was so good. And if you don't know who Quincy Jones is, I recommend you look him up, because he is an incredible musician, music producer, writer of movie soundtracks and scores, and he produced some of the most famous artists of all time. He's very well known for producing Michael Jackson's Off the Wall and Thriller, and won all kinds of Grammys and all these things. And also, he worked with lots of big-time artists back in the day, and one of those artists is Billy Eckstein, who I'm a big fan of, so I want to just give a shout out to him as well. And you know, I know so many people that, you know, has crossed his path, and I got to meet Quincy one time. My manager actually took me to a Grammy event, and he knows Quincy Jones very well. So we got to meet Quincy, and that was very, very cool. So I got to be kind of a second generation of somebody that has worked with Quincy, and he was telling me, you know, that's great, you're doing music, stick with it, you know, and he gave me some really good advice to enjoy the music as I go up in my career. So that was really great. He won many, many Grammys, yes. I think he might have the record, as far as I've heard. Somebody, yeah, I think he may have the most Grammys, at least nominations and wins. I'm not sure how it tallies up, but yeah, very, very good musician. And, you know, interesting story. So if you watch the documentary, it's on Netflix. It's a really interesting story of, you know, for me, somebody was very inspiring, and also, you know, just understanding kind of the behind the scenes of the music industry, and, you know, the struggle and the joy of everything that we do as artists to continue this pursuit of our dreams and our art, you know, so.
Yeah, I know he was born in my hometown of Chicago.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's right. Yes, he said he was born in the south side of Chicago. That's right. He mentions that in the documentary too, and talks about growing up there.
Yeah, I'll have to watch that.
Yeah, you have to. It's really good.
Yeah, I'll watch that and Noises Off.
Ah, yes. Noises Off. My favorite movie of all time. Yes, absolutely. You got to watch it.
Okay, well, thank you for all of your time tonight.
Yes, absolutely. Thank you for calling and for your embarrassing moment story. That was funny.
Okay, you are awesome.
Oh, like thank you, Michael. I will see you. And thank you again for the donation last week. I appreciate you.
Okay.
And the gift.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Okay. Okay. I'm going to do a song for you guys in just a minute, but I wanted to say hi to some of the chatters out there. You guys are chatting, and I appreciate it. So thank you for being here. and so you guys are wondering, some of you have been kind of following along, and it's changed a little bit as we go. So now, if you want the phone number to call, you join my website, which is jenniferdaystuff.com. And if you want to interact with me through chat, if you do a donation, just, you know, a dollar or more, whatever you want to do, and then you put either a question or a comment in the message, then I will say your name and we can interact that way. I can answer your question or make a comment on your comment. So you could do that. You won't get the phone number by a donation. I changed that. So now if you want the number, you join my website. Now, if you're curious about what my website is, I'll put it up on the screen. So you just go to jenniferdaystuff.com. And that's where you can enjoy all of my movies, my music, my videos, and pictures of me and my girlfriends. And it's so much fun, and I really appreciate it. So it's only $5 to join. And then you can have access to all of me and my girlfriends and all of the content that I make whenever you want. So there's tons of stuff on there. It'll take you forever to get through it all. I'm trying to, you know, have my own J-Day Netflix version, right? So that's the idea. So the reason I want to do it that way is because I want to appreciate you, those of you who really like what I do and want to see more and join and become a member. Then you get the number and then you can call and we can interact that way. And also, I stopped posting the number because I'm, you know, there's been lots of craziness, and I'm trying to keep the negative energy out and the racial slurs. That's the reason. So I'm just trying to have that completely cut off. I don't want to hear it. And I know nobody else does either. So we're keeping the show positive and light and fun. So all of you guys who want to call and chat and keep it positive and hang out with me in a positive way, then awesome. Let's keep the show rocking like that. Yay. So on that note, I'm going to sing a song for you guys, as requested by Michael. This is a new one for a lot of you guys, so it's me getting a little rocker on here, so in my very tight dress. We'll see how this goes. It's like a rubber band. I hope it doesn't fly off.
Opposite attraction goes a long way. Physical love fills an energy well. Others don't get how well we gel. They only see the tension. They can't believe how long we've been together. How can that be? You don't give me answers. I sit and wait. I know that you love me. I'm so unsure. You never straight up with me. Same detour. Tell the truth. There is no doubt. That is the only way we'll figure things out. If you don't give me answers, I just can't wait. I know that you love me, but that's not all it takes. It takes. It takes. It's not all it. Say the words and you know I'm yours. See us so happy by the seashore. We want the same things, let's proceed. But if we don't, then I can't leave. Please don't be selfish. I wanna stay, but you know that I can't help it. If you don't see eye to eye, you don't give me answers. I sit and you love me, that part's great. think of the future. I'm so unsure. You never straight up with me, same detour. Tell the truth, there is no doubt. That is the only way we'll figure things out. If you don't give me answers, I just can't wait. I know that you love me. Can you take a chance with me? Advance with me, enhance with me, I feel this. The future, I'm so unsure. You're never straight up with me, same detour. Tell the truth, there is no doubt. That is the only way to figure things out. If you don't give me answers, I just can't wait. I know that you love me, but that's not all it takes. Not all it takes. Tell the truth, there is no doubt. That is the only way we'll figure things out. If you don't give me answers, I just can't wait. I know that you love me, but that's not all it takes.
Yeah, that was fun. Rocking it out with you guys, yay. Jennifer Rocker Chick, right? I know I'm usually a little bit like smoother and more ballet, but I thought I'd have a little fun with some rocking it out for you. All right. Hello, you're on live with Jennifer. How's it going?
Hey, what's up, Jennifer? How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Oh, good. It's like I'm watching. This is crazy. It's like I'm watching on my tablet, on my phone, talking to you guys, and I'm watching. I guess I'm trying to watch you at the same time, you know.
Nice.
A lot of times when I get, sometimes I'm embarrassing. Sometimes I think one time I did get kind of embarrassing when I send too many emails to people and they tell me not to do it. So it's probably not good. I did send a lot of emails to certain people, and I guess I know why. Because a lot of times it gets kind of old, and then they don't call me back. So I just. I'll try not to overdo it. You know?
Well, you send me a lot of pictures and videos, and I do watch some of them when I can get to it. So yeah, a lot of the car videos and stuff, and super cute pictures of the dogs and the kitties. Oh my gosh, I was like, oh, like you can't see a picture of a really cute dog or cat and like not be completely overwhelmed with cuteness. Yeah. You know, it's adorable. Yeah.
I also seen one with a killer whale talking to each other, killer whales, I just wanted to call you because, you know, a lot of times, I didn't call you Monday because I called you Sunday, so I didn't want to call twice in a row, and a lot of times when you get calls, and, you know.
Oh, for like, the Cinco de Mayo show, right,
Yeah, but I enjoyed it. It was fun. And then also, I just had a request. Maybe when you say you can send me the video of Lisa and Alex. I think I have one of those videos. You did send me a video a long time ago, but I think so talk so fast. I think that I might scratch.
So you're saying at the end of the show, you want me to play a video of Lisa and Alex? That's what you mean?
Whoa. Well, no, it's like, I just want to, maybe you can send it to me later on for my birthday.
You the video. Of course. Yeah. Send you a DVD of them. Yeah, absolutely. They are so much fun. They were in quite a few TV show episodes and a movie that I did. So we had so much fun together. Those girls are awesome. Great energy. Lisa's studying to be a lawyer now. So shout out to Lisa. You go, girl.
Cool. Yeah, like I said, sometimes embarrassing moments can be some, like, you know, jokes with friends, you know, and, you know, people and jokes at each other, you know, sometimes it happens, sometimes just kind of, just like your show, sometimes people call you, you don't know who's calling you, so I just try to be positive, you know, I mean.
Yeah, that's good. I know, whenever something, like, embarrassing and silly happens to you, it's kind of like, you might as well just laugh. at the moment too, yeah. You know, like I have this oh, one yeah. story where I was coming back from visiting my family in Michigan. And so my sister, who yeah. also lives in LA, we were flying back together and we were, oh my gosh, yeah. from a long week of vacationing with, you know, lots of kids and the family and everything, we were so tired. So uh-huh. we were a little yeah. bit kind of slap happy and we were yeah. walking along the yeah. airport. Laughing yeah. and giggling. And if any of you guys know me, I can show you my heels. I have these little fun yeah. stilettos. I wear these yeah. all the time, even when I go to Michigan. So I was wearing some yeah. stilettos in the airport carrying my bag yeah. and we're, you know, tired and yeah. laughing. And I'm just kind of walking along, looking at my sister and we're talking. I like literally did a wipeout, like onto the floor yeah. and there's people yeah. walking along and they turn around yeah. like, is she okay? Yeah. I just busted yeah. out laughing. It was so funny. My sister's yeah. crying laughing. She yeah. she got on the floor yeah. with me. It was laughing so hard. I couldn't even get up yeah. for a minute. I was like, this is so funny. Like yeah. I can't believe I was I'm yeah. like all glamorous in my high heels and boom, all the way down.
Yeah.
it was so crazy.
Yeah. Yeah, but maybe I was thinking maybe later on, because I know you have a lot of calls, I wanted to take a lot of your time. Maybe one day you can see you, just one night, I'm just trying to figure out when you can see
yes,
you.
Yes, yes. And I know last week you had asked me, or a couple weeks ago, you had asked me to sing Take Me Back, and I sang it on Monday night, but... You know, because we were having some technical difficulties, I don't know if you guys got to really hear it the way that it should yeah. be. So I'm going to sing yeah. that for you again tonight. And then I'm going to keep working on the other song, Just One Night, and I can maybe do that for you next week.
Yeah. Hey, listen, I just want to tell you one more thing before I hang up. I just want to say I really enjoy the motto. What's the name? Monica. What's her name?
Monica from Cinco de Mayo special. Yeah, if you guys missed it, it's up on my YouTube page. So you just go there and look for the video of me in the big pink sombrero, and you'll see Monica. She is a very famous and beautiful model, and she was dancing on the show. And then I also had the gorgeous and talented Isabel come sing with me. So that was super fun. So if you guys missed the Cinco de Mayo special, because it was on a Sunday, so you guys go to YouTube and check that out, and you can watch the replay.
Anyway, I just want to say thanks for the show, as always. You know, like I said, I just like calling when I can. I try not to call when anybody else, because I know sometimes your show gets kind of hectic, you know.
You've been a really cool fan and follower and friend for a long time, so I appreciate you, and I appreciate that you watch every week and call. That's awesome.
Thanks. I just want to thank you for the pictures that you sent me. I might not send you I would like to send you a donation someday. I just got to figure out what I can word right now, kind of tight budget. Well, I mean, I'll work it out one of these days. You know,
well,
I do like
you.
I still have the pictures. Huh?
Thank you. I appreciate that. Yeah, I appreciate that you just are here watching every week. That's very cool.
Yeah. The movies. I just haven't been able to get too much. I I watch stuff on YouTube. You know, like car shows. You know. Yeah, but nice. Listen, we'll talk to you next week, and I'll try to find some little stuff. I saw this girl with a tiger. I don't know if I might have said she was a girl. She was a teenager. She's like 17 years old, and she was had a pet tiger.
That's kind of crazy, but I guess awesome at the same time, right?
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much.
I'll talk to you later. Have a good night. See you next week. Bye.
Thank you, Cecil. Bye. And I'm going to thank you for calling and thank you for your fun stories. I appreciate it.
Bye.
Okay. Bye.
Bye.
Hello, you're on Live with Jennifer. How's it going?
Hi, Jennifer.
Hey, Betty. How are you?
I'm fine.
Hey, Betty.
Good. Welcome back. Yay.
So let you know, I got my package today.
Awesome! Yay! Good! I hope you like everything.
Yay! Good! I hope you like everything.
Oh, I love it. I just have to know when to do the other half of yours. Okay.
Oh, well, thank you. Yay, I'm so glad.
Did you get it?
I'm so glad you like.
Well, you know, I'm listening to your thing, and I couldn't really think of anything way back when in school, but there's something to me was just so stupid. I was on my way to the clinic, you know, for the vet, and I get outside, and I go to get in the car, and I'm like, oh, my gosh, I forgot my keys to the house, and my cell phone was in the house. And I'm like, oh, my gosh. So I went to my neighbor, and we're both just laughing about it. Because I'm like, what do I do? Because I was very fortunate he had John's number on his cell phone. But I had to wait for Matthew. But that was so stupid.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, yes. I've done that where you leave without your phone, and then you're like,
oh, yeah, I had to call work.
I think I have to turn around because, yeah, we really can't function without our phones these days.
Well, I called work and I felt so ridiculous telling them I'm going to be a little late and telling them why.
Yeah, and then you feel really embarrassed because you're like, this is totally my fault. I totally messed up. I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's like, don't ever be in a hurry, you know?
How do we do that? We're always in a hurry these days, right? There's not enough hours in a day.
Well, so, did you get the stuff we sent you? Do I need to send the other half now?
Oh, okay, yes. So I'm actually going to check tomorrow when I can go to my mailbox. So I will check tomorrow.
Okay. All righty. So.
Yeah, thank you. Hi, John. Is John there?
Oh, yeah, he's here.
Ah, nice.
You said hi?
Hi.
You said hi.
Hi. Yes, yeah, so I wanted to tell you, Betty, you had requested me to sing Take Me Back, I think a week ago or so, and I sang it last week on Monday, but I don't know how much of the show you got to see or hear on Monday, so I'm going to sing it again for you tonight. So in a minute here, I'm going to sing that for you guys, all right?
Cool.
Yay.
Right.
Yeah,
cool. You know, your dress has a starburst of it. You can see pink and orange.
Ooh, okay.
Pink, orange.
Let me give it a little walk for you.
Oh.
Let me give it a little walk for you.
All right.
Oh. Is it changing colors?
Oh, yeah,
dancing in the lights.
It had a tangerine orange. Beautiful.
Oh, yeah, thank you.
Orange, beautiful.
Yay.
Did
I like having colorful dresses. Oh, and also, Betty, happy Mother's Day from this weekend. I hope you had a really wonderful Mother's Day with your family.
Oh, I had a ball.
Oh, good.
Yeah, me and the girls and John, that we went out for dinner, and then the girls took me before dinner, and I got another ear piercing.
Oh, that's an interesting Mother's Day gift. I got my ear pierced.
Yeah.
How about that?
Yeah.
You said another, as in, how many do you have?
Let me think. I think it's six on each side.
Six? Like six piercings in one ear?
Well, I have one, but the one I did yesterday, I think they call it a conch. It's inside the ear itself.
Huh. Okay, like at the top?
And then above the earlobe. I've got some up there. It's, you know, they're just a little bit different, but I got a couple that are like in the cartilage, like your... I can't see what it's called, but yeah.
Oh, okay. Wow. Yeah, I've seen some really unique piercings, like especially in the last 10 years or so. I think that people have gotten really creative, you know, and finding new ways to be artistic with their bodies and like either piercing or tattoo and those kind of things. Yeah, so that's cool. You got something new like that. See, look, you're just a young and wild mama, huh?
I like when you on one of your shows. I like on one of your shows when you talked about your belly button ring.
Oh, yes.
I have one too, and I told John, she's got the same one.
Nice. Yeah, you can't see today, but I think last week I had a two-piece on. You could see it.
I liked how you mentioned to your mom. I know when I got mine, I came home and surprised John. I'm like, oh, look what I got.
Ta-da!
He always gets surprised with stuff. So.
Oh, really? He should know you by now, right? That you're just going to come home and surprise him sometimes.
Yeah.
Nice.
I don't think he totally does, Jennifer.
Oh. Well, you know, every day, you're always learning something new about your partner, right?
John wanted me to tell you this.
He bought me a beautiful guitar.
Oh, that's beautiful. Oh, wow. So how's that going? Are you starting to learn?
For you, you know. So.
Yeah. Do you already know how to play?
I'm going to go down and talk with someone about it, but it's somewhat.
Oh, okay. That's good. Well, maybe you could play something for me someday.
I played a song for my mom.
Oh, that's nice.
It's basically wanting to learn, you can take small chords or you use your, because I got short fingers, so the guy's going to teach me how to, you can use actually less chords and make the same sound.
Oh, right, okay. Yeah, that's good. It's good to have a teacher and then you can, you know, learn some technique and
I'll give you a
cool
picture
tricks.
Of that, though.
Yeah. I would love to hear that. You can play me some, like, Rolling Stones or something, right?
Though. It's so beautiful.
I would love to hear that. You can play me some, like, Rolling Stones or something, right?
Oh, it's so beautiful. Oh, John goes, you wish. I'd like to learn something from Guns N' Roses.
Ooh, yeah. Play me some Guns N' Roses. Yeah, when you have some, you know, some lessons under your belt, then when you call me and, you know, we're listening on the air, you can play something on the air for everybody. Be my guest artist.
Maybe. I sing a lot of your songs. You know, when you're singing here,
yeah.
I'll be singing right along with you.
Oh, yay. That's fun. Well, thank you. Thank you for calling and for the fun, embarrassing moment story. And I'm going to sing that song for you in a little bit, all right?
Love you.
Okay. Love you guys, too. Bye, Betty. Bye, John. Hello, you're on Live with Jennifer. How's it going?
Hi, Jennifer. It's Joe from Jersey. How are you tonight?
Hey, I'm good. How are you, Joe, my traveling man out there?
Yeah, I'm home again tonight. So it's almost 2 weeks in a row.
Wow. You must be getting restless.
Yes, just a bit.
Right.
Yeah, maybe get on the road next week again. So we'll see.
Oh, nice. That sounds good. So, do you have a fun, embarrassing moment for me?
Well, in a way, it's a recurring embarrassing moment.
Oh, goodness.
I don't know how to exactly explain it, but let's say that you were going out to dinner with a date, and he you have a nice night, and everything goes well at dinner. And the date, you know, when he picks up his napkin, he tucks it into his belt, and then the night goes on, and maybe there's a drink or two, and then you get up and you leave the restaurant and you walk through a crowded place with a lot of people, and you notice that your date didn't take the napkin off his lap, and he's been walking around with it covering his crotch while you're walking around for about an hour.
Oh my goodness, so this happened to you several times?
Unfortunately, yes.
Oh my goodness.
And it usually has something to do with the number of drinks that I had with dinner.
Oh, right. Yeah, that will affect your your ability to pay attention when you stand up.
So my mind was probably wandering a little bit. Yeah, but it's happened a couple of times. I, I try to be sensitized to it, but it does tend to happen.
Well, I mean, that has happened to me too, but I don't usually have anything to tuck it into, so I just kind of lay it on my lap, but then I'll get up and you walk away from the table and it just kind of falls.
Yeah, then at least it falls off.
Right, so you're not walking through the restaurant. Yeah. But then sometimes I'm just like, you know, you kind of like almost trip. You're like, what am I standing on? Oh, gosh. You know, that was me. I should have paid attention to my napkin. I know. Well, and sometimes they'll have it like, and it's the same color as what you're wearing. Like, you know, if you have black pants, right, and they have a black napkin, you know, obviously you're not thinking, you know.
Yeah, but if it's red or bright green, it doesn't
then,
really quite go.
Then it's a little more obvious when you're walking
pants
through.
Bright green pants. So,
right.
Yeah. So well, I thought about that when you said it. Yeah, I can't think of a single one, but this was a recurring thing.
Right. Well, yeah, I guess now you'll, at the very next time you go to the restaurant, maybe you'll think about it. But the time after that, maybe you'll have to.
I should write myself a note or something before I go out. I don't know.
Yeah, exactly.
Would be a good idea. So.
Oh, that's funny. Thank you for that fun story.
Yeah, well. That's all I got for tonight for that.
Okay.
So, I was just noticing how nice your trees and stuff look in the back of your set. I think they were back there for last week, but there were so many trees it was hard to tell what was there.
Right. Yeah. And I kind of just smothered it with trees.
Yes.
Yeah. You know, going forward, I can, you know, kind of be like, you know, kind of piece some things together and have a little different design each week, which is nice. So, yeah, I wanted it, you know, super festive for Cinco de Mayo and to just have it kind of be wild, different set, tropical and all that stuff. So, yeah, but this is I thought would be fun for today.
Yeah, it looks pretty. It really does.
Oh, thank you.
So I was going to ask you to do something for me tonight. I have a couple of old, not old songs, but I have like three or four favorite songs of yours. And I would like you to figure out which one you'd like to sing to me tonight.
Oh, okay.
I'll give you a choice, okay?
Okay.
So let me see. Let me think. I got to figure out what I want to listen to. Well, I think the ones I'd like, so pick from this set of four. I'd like Human, Two Hearts, Flying, and then something I think you called My Medicine, My Poison.
Yes, yeah, okay. That's a good list.
All right, so
I will pick one.
If you can sing one of those to me tonight, I'll sit here and watch you very carefully.
Oh, thank you.
Okay.
Thank you. I appreciate that request. Thank you. I'll pick one of those and sing it for you later on tonight.
Sounds good. And
yay.
And I had some good news today about work, so I'm really quite on a high tonight. So
good. Well,
really
congrats.
Good. So, all right, and keep up the good work, and we'll be looking for you in the next couple of weeks on Monday nights.
Awesome. Thank you. All right, Traveling Joe. I'll talk to you next Monday.
Okay, will do. All right, bye, John.
Bye.
Bye.
That's fun. So I did want to say thank you for a few more donations. So I had some donations from last week that I didn't get to, and then some donations for this week, so I wanted to get to those. So I want to say thank you for a donation from JFJ. Awesome. I really appreciate it. You're helping me do all of this every week, so thank you. Let me give you a little twirl. Just a live twirl. And I want to say thank you to Booty Lover. Thank you so much for your donation. I really appreciate it. I'll give you a center camera booty shot. There we go. There's your booty shot, Booty Lover. Yay. I know what you like. You're obvious about it, huh? Yay. I want to say thank you to Eugene for your donation last week. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. So I'll give you a little shimmy. Thank you. Yay. Little fun shimmy. Thank you, Eugene. And I want to say thank you to Mike L. for your donation. Thank you so much. I'll get you your own camera. I'll do a little swerve for you. And a little kiss. Mwah. Thank you, Mike L. I appreciate it. Oh, and I want to say thank you for a donation from Ebenezer last week. I didn't get to it, so I want to make sure I say thank you. I really appreciate it. So I will also give you a little walk around. Yay. I call that strut that stuff, so I'm strutting my stuff for you, Ebenezer. Thank you. And I want to say thank you to S.C. James. Thank you so much for your donation last week. It was so generous. I really appreciate it. So generous of all of you guys. So S.C. James, I'm going to give you a little shimmy on this camera. Yay. And a little back arch for you. And one of my favorite poses. There you go. Thank you so much for the donation. You guys all are so wonderful. I really appreciate it. And also, I said thank you in person when you called, but Michael in Colorado, thank you so much for your donation. I really appreciate it. So another kiss. Thank you. And I know you call every week, but I appreciate the donation too. That's very cool. So you guys, as promised, I have a request for a song from Cecil, and Betty requested this song. Betty and John, you guys requested this. And I sang it last week on Monday, but I wanted to sing it again for you guys so we get a really nice rendition for you. All right, how's my hair? Here we go.
Take me back, take me back.
Papi, sé que te lastimé.
Take me back, take me back.
Pero te necesito.
Take me back, take me back.
Por favor, perdóname.
Take me back, take me back.
Llévame, mi amor. One more chance to show you my love.
Take me back, take me back.
I hurt you and I don't know why.
Take me back, take me back.
Will you give me one more try?
Take me back, take me back.
I love you and that's a fact. Please believe me when I say I'm so sorry. I could have this much heartache. You are my one and only. It's true, I only wanna be with you. I'm ashamed and I regret it, baby, baby. And I know you'll never forget it. I gave into lust when all I wanted was your trust. Look into my eyes. Did you wrong? But if you let me
you guys for requesting that song. And it was kind of fun because, you know, last weekend I had the Cinco de Mayo special and I got to do some of my Español para ustedes. So that was fun. And I had, of course, this song with some Spanish in it. So I thought we'd have a little fun with that too. Yay. If you like that song, and especially if you speak Spanish and you're interested to hear a song of mine with some Spanish in it, that song is on my Sweet Daydreams album, which is on iTunes, Spotify, Google Play, Amazon, Pandora, iHeartRadio, all of those. So you can stream it. And then it's also on my website, jenniferdaystuff.com. So if you're already a member, you can listen to it there. That was my album that was released through Universal Thump Records. So shout out to Universal Music and Thump Records. You guys are awesome. Thank you for hooking it up and, you know, sharing Jennifer Day with the world. Yay! So for all of you guys who are maybe tuning in for the first time and you're like, what is this show all about? So I am Jennifer Day, and I obviously just sang one of my original songs for you guys. I'm also an actress, so I have a lot of movies that I've done. If you are curious to see more about me, you can go to my website. It's put it up on the screen for you. It's jenniferdaystuff.com. So I would love if you want to become a member. It's only $5 or $10 a month. And then if you want to just check it out for a little bit, see how you like it, it's $20 for a trial. And I really appreciate it. That's how I'm able to continue doing this show every week. So you'll get to listen to all my music, watch all my movies and my videos, TV show episodes, live concert videos, all kinds of fun stuff. And then I have my girlfriends on there, you know, dancing with me, bikini girls, all kinds of fun videos. So you will enjoy tons of stuff. It'll take you forever to get through it. So I really appreciate it. And also, a lot of you guys have my app. Yay! And I really appreciate that. So if you don't, and you are looking for a fun way to wake up in the morning, you can get my app. So you just go to your app store or your Play Store and you search Jennifer Day Calendar is the name of the app. And it's free to install it. So you get a one-day free trial. And how it works is you get a video of me. I tell you the date, a fun little message, and then I dance for you to my music in a sexy little outfit. And if you subscribe for $3, then you get a brand new video every day forever. And you can have this video be your alarm clock. So you just set the time and it will wake you up in the morning. So instead of you will hear a lovely song and me talking to you and whispering sweet nothings in your ear to wake you up in the morning. A much better way to wake up, I think. Maybe some incentive to actually wake up and open your eyes instead of just rolling over, right? So that's the idea. So you have something fun to look forward to. And each day you're going to get a brand new video, new song, new outfit, a new dance, a new little fun little message from me. So you get 365 new videos so each year. So I appreciate it. And so if you get the app and you like it, give me 5 stars. I appreciate it. If you don't like it, don't do anything. Just leave it alone. If you love it, give me 5 stars. And then, of course, email me and tell me that you have it and you like it and all that stuff. So thank you. I just wanted to give you guys an idea of some of the things that I do. And of course, I had another request for a song, so I'm going to sing you guys another song. Yay. Here we go. So this one was requested by Joe from Jersey. So he gave me a choice of 4 songs. So I haven't sang this one in a while. So this is Two of Hearts, and it's also on my Sweet Daydreams album. So you can check it out there as well. This is for Joe from Jersey, a.k.a. Traveling Man. Thank you so much for the request and the donation. Thank you. We'll be right back. I wasn't gonna tell nobody. No, baby. But desperate lover, I can't keep it to myself. Oh, no. Oh, oh. When we're together, it's like hot coals and fire. Hot, baby. My body's burning, so come on.
Together like candy love.
thank you guys so much for being here with me every Monday night. I really appreciate it. And by the way, that's no lip syncing. I never lip sync. I sing live every week. And so I appreciate you guys for coming back and being here and all the donations and all of you guys who have become members of my website. Thank you so much. It means a lot to me that you stick with me every week, every month, and help me continue to do this. It means a lot, and I really enjoy it. So thank you. And as always, I'm sending you a smile. Stick around for the video after the show, and I'll see you next week.